aka new covenant, aka will. And according to Hebrews chapter 8, a will cannot be enforced until the one who wrote the will dies. Do you understand that? That's why the way the King James put it is that you cannot enforce a covenant, a testament, until the death of the testator. The word testator there is the one who wrote the will. So you can't enforce a will until the man who writes the will dies. Is that okay? So who wrote the New Testament will? Who wrote the New Testament will? Jesus. If Jesus was the one who wrote the New Testament will, when does it take effect? When he was still here or after he has died? The will takes effect after he has died. Therefore, when you hear the kingdom is at hand, you cannot repeat that after he has died. Because he came, John was introducing, he said, the kingdom we'll be talking about is at hand now. It's at hand, it's at hand. And I will show you how Jesus now approached it. Now, because a lot of things that Jesus did before, that is pre-cross days, pre his death on the cross, pre-crucifixion, were no longer tenable after his death. Okay, he healed some lepers. He told them to go to the temple to do what? Offer the things that Moses commanded you. Show yourself to the priest. But after the cross, after he has resurrected, which of the disciples ever instructed people to go back to the priest? Their ministry was invalidated by the ministry of Christ, the high priest. Do you understand what I'm saying? So you need to understand when the New Testament really took effect. Let's read another passage. I think that might help you. Now, the progression of the kingdom was that John was saying, the kingdom is at hand. The kingdom is at hand. Now, move on to the next verse in Matthew chapter 12, verse 28. Matthew chapter 12, verse 28. Hear what Jesus says there. Matthew 12, 28. All right. But if I cast out devils by the Spirit of God, read that next line.